YouTube, welcome back to my channel. Ooh. I'm coming to you with a muck-bang, whatever it's called. I got my Chick-Fila right here. You wanna say hey?
Gotta put me on
mama,
this right. That's just rude.
I'm coming with a mukbang, and you know I got my Chick-Fila with me. I didn't. My mama took so long. Like, I'm not riding in the car with her no more because, like, let me tell you, everybody out getting food, right? Oh, I forgot to say, follow me on Instagram at Catch Some Cherry Vibes, and yeah, let's get into the video. So today I'm gonna do a mukbang. I ate half of the food because my mama took so long to just get home. Like, I shouldn't have rode in the car with her. Like, I should have just went and got my food and came back. So now half my food is eaten and half my food is cold, but it's okay because I love Chick-fil-A. So I got some half eaten fries, but baby, it's okay. And I ain't eat my nuggets though. I eat my nuggets. And I got all the beautiful sauces. Y'all know my favorite sauce. Y'all like Chick-fil-A sauce and barbecue sauce? Because these are my favorite sauces. Like, every time I go Chick-fil-A, I need my Chick-fil-A sauce and my barbecue sauce, okay? And sometimes I don't end up eating one sauce, but hey, you know, sometimes you can just save it for the next time. And I got a Oreo milkshake and a water because, you know what I'm saying? I believe all black people are lactose intolerant. I'm lactose intolerant. My stomach gonna be hurting, and you know what I'm saying? So, let's get into this. Let's get into it. Even though they cold, it still tastes so good. Like, whoever created Chick-fil-A, whoever came up with these recipes, y'all really the goat. I don't care what nobody said. Y'all really the goat, because I can always eat Chick-fil-A. Like, I'm always okay to eat Chick-fil-A. Like, you know how sometimes you like, nah, I don't want Burger King, or nah, I'm not feeling Wendy's.
I'm always feeling Chick-fil-A. Like.
Mm-hmm. And especially because we've been on quarantine. So, a bitch been eating at home a lot. So, y'all like my feet. I don't know how this lighting gonna be because the sun going down, but just bear with me because y'all must have been caught up. Today is my papa, the GOAT's birthday. He passed away in 2018. He is one of the most inspiring people to me. And you know, let me show you a picture of the GOAT. This is my papa, y'all. His name was Robert Lee Simpson. And y'all, he taught shit like I taught shit. And he is an entrepreneur, and I feel like it's, y'all not gonna be able to see the goat like that. There he go. It's his birthday today, so like, I was gonna paint a picture of him, but Hobby Lobby was closed, so I couldn't get me a canvas and everything. But yeah, this is the goat right here. This is my papa, my everything, my heart. He was just everything. I know that's my guardian angel. A dab like this. Do it, do it. Oh, dab! Oh. Woo!
Oh, oh, oh. Home still.
I fought for you the hardest. It made me the strongest. So tell me your secret.
to be there.
I just can't stand to see you leave.
Oh, Lord, don't
couldn't wait for you.
Because I gotta make it. He right here with me. He really talking shit with me. And we ready. So yeah, it's the ghost birthday today. So happy birthday to you, Papa. We going up. So how are y'all doing with the quarantine? Like, are y'all being productive, or are y'all just Netflix and chilling? Or is it about the same, or do you just sleep all day? Me, I've been half productive, half sleep, and I don't really watch TV like that, so I ain't Netflix and chilling. But productive wise, I've been taking care of my skin. Like, I got this new face wash, because my face is that type of skin that...
Wait, what did I just say?
My face is that type of skin that... My skin is that type of skin where it's half oily and half, like, dry. In my T-zone area, it's really oily, but, like, I be getting dry patches still. So, I use this avocado face wash. I'm gonna put it right here, and it's avocado moisturizer. And it's been doing wonders for my face. I have no foundation on, and my face looks so amazing. Like, I only got my eyebrows and my eyelashes on, y'all. So, yeah. And then, I know I'm wearing a wig, y'all.
Oh, my God!
But I really been taking care of my real hair. Like, hopefully, by the end of this quarantine, I won't be bald-headed no more. Like... I will wear my natural hair, but the curl patterns be everywhere. Like, I have four different curl patterns. Like, that nappy curl pattern. Not nappy, because I don't want, like, some girls have that curl pattern and it looks good on them. But that kinky, real kinky. Then I have really little tiny spirals, and then I have big curls. So it's like damaged hair, that kinky, curly, big curls, and little spiral curls. And it's just like, that shit do not look good, like, on one head. Like, four different textures do not look good. So I'm just trying to change my hair and take care of my hair and love my hair. So before I put on this wig, like, I take this wig off all the time. Like, I'm not wearing this wig all the time. Like, I gotta itch my head. I'm not about to go like, dude, that ain't me. This could hurt your head. I don't see how girls just keep wigs on and just be just patting their head like that. That is not me. Baby, this wig coming off. I don't care. This wig coming off. But yeah, I've been taking care of my hair. So this is what I do. I wash my hair. I co-wash my hair every week. And then every 3 weeks, I wash my hair, like, with the shampoo and a deep conditioner. But, and then I put this mask on, let the mask sit on my hair for, like, 30 minutes, and then I rinse it out, and I do that like every 3 weeks. But every week I'll actually deep condition my hair, but I won't put the shampoo in my hair. I'll just deep condition it, or conditioner. And then I'll get a spray bottle, and I got some moisturizer and some oil, and then I'll wet my hair, and then I'll put the moisturizer on, and then I'll put the oil on there, and then I'll braid it in like four plaits. So underneath this wig, it's like I look like Felicia off of Friday, but with shorter ponytails, because Felicia low-key had long ass hair. Like, I'm not gonna lie to you, it's longer than mine. But by the end of this quarantine, baby, I got hang time. But yeah, I'm just keeping it real with you. Like, Some people gonna look at this video and be like, oh my god. Oh well, girl. Oh well. Get over yourself. But, yeah. I've been taking care of myself on quarantine, baby. I gotta get out of quarantine. And then, I've been exercising the days that I'm off. But it's really hard. Like, before quarantine, I was really exercising, like, I was really, really exercising. I get distracted. But before quarantine happened, I was going to the gym. I was going to Planet Fitness with me and my friend. And we was going faithfully, baby. Faithfully. Like, if we were still going, I probably would have a six pack in a little. But, I mean, I'm not flat. I'm still a little stripper, you know. Let me show y'all my baby. See ya. She's still bad though. I'm saying, I'm not like big booty Judy yet. When I become big booty Judy, I don't think none of y'all gonna be able to tell me nothing. Like, and then I just have to have a butt because it's like, if this don't work out, stripper life. Stripper life. Yeah. If college don't work out, stripper life. And let me tell you about these college classes. Like, I got this old teacher. He my English teacher. This man talking about we gotta do presentations on Blackboard, cause he can go like live on Blackboard or whatever. And I'm just thinking, like, how can we do presentations when we on a computer? Like, isn't that presentation gonna be on a computer? So I don't know. He better have it figured out. At work, I'm talking about work. People be looking me up and down. I work in the kitchen. If it be too many people, I'ma start coughing. I know that's wrong. I ain't gonna say that, y'all. Y'all might put me. I gotta watch what I say on here. Can't be too real. I might get fired. Let me not say nothing. Another thing I've been doing during quarantine is I've been trying to meditate. I really want my dreams to come true. So one thing that I know Charity needs to work on to be successful, to be the millionaire that I'm finna be in a few years, I have to train myself to get tasks done. I know how to be successful. I know if I do these YouTube videos consistently, coming up with creative ideas and being interactive with social medias and just give my all, that I know I can make it and I know I can be successful. But, oh, and put God first and just manifest it and believe that I'm gonna do it, I can do it. But it's like my laziness and my overthinking and my anxiety is just obstacles that I just gotta overcome. And it's just so hard to overcome it because you actually gotta do the overcoming. Like, it's not gonna come to you. It's not gonna be a scratch off where you just win the lottery. No, you're gonna have to work your ass off to be successful. So I'm just gonna have to work my butt off to be successful. And so what I've been doing is I've been just like trying to be organized with everything that I have to get done. So I gotta concentrate on school. I gotta concentrate on this YouTube stuff. I gotta be up to date with social media. I gotta while that's going, I gotta work, and then I gotta come home and help my mom with the house. So it's like a lot. It's a lot. And I'm just gotta figure out how to manage all of those things, all those different charities, and organize them where I can get everything done to be the successful person. Because it's being a lazy, easy person, it's easy. It's easy. And it's broke too. Is broke. Unless you hit the lottery, being lazy and easy, taking the easy route, is broke. I'm gonna take the hard route for right now, so when I do get old, me and my old man, we can be lazy because we got the money. I don't got the money right now. I need that money. I need that moolah. I need to be somebody. I need to be inspiring somebody. I cannot imagine myself just working a 9-to-5 job when I'm grown. Like, no, I can't do that. Like, that's not me. That's not Charity. Like, I want to be creative when I work. I want to have purpose. I want to inspire people. I want to connect with people. Like, I can't wait till I get to the point where I actually have a support group or somebody who actually is inspired by me, because like I'm going to be so interactive with my people. I know so many famous people who don't like recognize that you cannot be nobody without people supporting you. So I'm going to give back to my supporting people. You can best believe when I got money, you got money. When I'm going up, we going up together. Like, I just can't wait. Can't wait. I know God got so much in play for me. It's crazy. One person who's really been inspiring to me is B. Simone, baby. It's only a few people that really want to take that hard route. You really got to work hard to be successful. If you really want it, you got to grind for it. And you know, some people just got it, like, good. They just born in a rich family and they just got it easy. And they don't really have a lot of obstacles they got to overcome. And me, I'm not going to have it as easy because I don't have that, but I'm thankful for that, because throughout this journey, it's going to be hardships, but I'm blessed to go through those hardships because it's just going to be a journey, and the journey is really the blessing. The journey is really the blessing. You're going to learn so much stuff. I'm not going to be as sensitive. I'm going to learn how to overcome anxiety. I'm going to learn how to be less lazy. I'm just going to be learning so much stuff throughout my journey so I can inspire other people who are just like me. So yeah, enough of that boring chit chat. I told y'all about work, told y'all what I've been doing on quarantine. Oh yeah, I'm about to propose to my best friend. Y'all know Kylie Jenner, how she proposed to Jordan. No, she didn't propose, they had a wedding. That's what I want to do with my best friend, because I just want to be rich and famous with my best friend. Like, yes, it's nice to have a dude, because I do have a little boo, but he know he getting annoyed at me. So, I need a girl to travel with me. And me and my best friend, we've been friends for the longest since, like, middle school. We are, like, a couple, like, we argue like cats and dogs. But it's, like, I wouldn't trade her for the world. Like, I love her. Yeah, my next video, y'all gonna see my boo. Y'all gonna see her. Y'all gonna see her. Y'all gonna see her. Let me tell you, I came so far, y'all. I used to work at McDonald's. I feel like that's like a lot of people's first jobs, but yeah, I used to work at McDonald's, and that job was fun, actually. I really had fun. I did a lot of stuff that I wasn't supposed to do. Like, let me tell y'all about this time I almost got caught. So when I was 16, I was talking to this dude, right? And I worked at McDonald's, and right beside McDonald's is a CVS. And, like, I don't know. I feel like when your first job, that's the first time for me. A lot of people were sneaking out the house, but I never really snuck out the house or did anything, like, bad or nothing. But I just had a little boo, and I never was allowed to have a boyfriend. So, you know, I was only seeing up on my breaks. And we just sitting in a car, but I was like, he was like, I'm gonna pull up at CVS. So I got off earlier than I told my mama. And when I got off, I went to CVS. And then I guess my mama pulled up early. And she was like calling me.
And she like, Charity, Charity, where you at? Where you at? They told me you been supposed to be off.
So I'm like, but mind you, y'all, I was in the car, you know, kissing, doing things that I got no business doing. And I put my phone, I'm dumb, I put my phone on the floor. If I would have just answered the phone, I probably would have saved my, excuse me, I probably would have saved myself, like, the stress and the struggle of how much I got in trouble. I wasn't allowed, she didn't trust me after that. She did not trust me. I wouldn't trust me. So, y'all, I told her that I got off at, like, 12, because I usually, sometimes I did get off at 12 at McDonald's, because McDonald's closed late. But basically, I put my phone on the floor and we was in his car and we was just talking, chopping it up. And then I picked up my phone. I had like 20 missed calls. Have y'all ever did that? Have y'all ever like dropped y'all phone and then be somewhere you ain't got no business, or have your phone turned off or something and your mama just call you like 20 times? Once you look at that phone and see how many missed calls you have, your heart just start racing. And I'm trying to play it cool because I don't want to look like, you know, like your mom. I'm just trying to act like she don't care and this is just what I do, just, you know what I'm saying? And then so I look at her and it's like, hello?
You know, she cuts me out. Charity, where the hell are you? Where the fuck are you? They said that you supposed to be off. Where are you? Where are you?
And I'm just like, I just went to CVS to go get some eyelashes.
They said you been off. They said you been off. Your ass better be here. You better be here. So
I was like, I gotta go. I ain't even give a kiss. Bye. I was gone. And so when I got back to McDonald's, she was just like so mad at me. I think she took my phone. I'm not sure, but yeah, I was kind of badass. I'm just kidding. But yeah. Oh yeah. So. Y'all want to know something about my papa? No, I love him so much, but that man was so crazy. He was so crazy. But, like, anytime I needed him, he was always there. Like, I don't know if y'all use y'all grandparents like I did, but in middle school, I always wanted to have those Papa John's pizzas. I just thought it was lame if you got lunch food. Like, from the cafeteria for real, because I know we had Papa John pizzas, we had slushies, we had wings. Like, we if you had a Papa John's pizza and a slushie, you was a shit. So I had to have it. I couldn't be looking like no lame. Like, no, people gonna be looking at me, what do you gotta eat, you know what I'm saying? So every day around lunchtime, like an hour before lunchtime, I'd be like, Papa, I go to the office because I didn't have a phone. So I go to the office and I be like, "Can I need to call my papa?" No, I did not. Yeah, I would go to the office and I'd be like, "I have to use the phone real quick." So I go,
"Papa, I need $10. Can you bring me $10? So we about to go on a field trip." Or I'd be like, "We need $10 for a textbook," or "I need another ID badge," or something.
And he'd be like, "Jared, you always need money every single day. But he'd be cussing me out, but you know what? He could bring it to me. And he'd bring me that food, that money, and I just have 2 slices of pizza. I was just eating. And I wasn't even hungry like that. I just wanted to have the food just to brag. So stupid. I was so stupid. So stupid. But, I'm full, y'all. Well, you guys, I know that was a little small little video, but you know what I'm saying? I didn't really know what to talk about, and I hope you like this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and yeah, just like, comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram, and yeah.